Mindhunter and Lion, the front three picks for Drinking Boys. What are your thoughts here, dude? I mean, Complexity, you know, we've been seeing a lot of Juggernaut. Seems like the hero is beginning to come back in vogue, at least in a miniature meta kind of a way. Sven, of course, being picked up a lot, as well as Oracle and Tide. Like, what's your initial thoughts as we look towards the final three picks here?
So Darkseer is pretty much like Swindle's one of his best heroes. Definitely one of the top heroes in this meta. You see Universe and Bulba playing this hero a lot. EG will take it every chance they get. Largely because like he's very efficient with the Iron Talon, and he provides so much utility to the team, and he has a lot of heroes in this meta combine really well with his Iron Shell Surge combo, like the Juggernaut and Sven's Lifestealers, all these type of heroes. Juggernaut popularized by OG, I think, like because people have realized that Juggernaut can also play mid as well as carry. So like you can pick him early like this, but also not be giving away too much. Timbersaw as well can be going off lane, can be going mid, but right now, obviously, he's probably been going mid. I think Oracle is kind of the pick that we've been seeing quite a bit, but I really just haven't been seeing it win. I haven't been seeing it be very effective.
Yeah.
Unless comboed up with something like DP, Alchemist, Huskar, something that's going to really abuse the ultimate, which is the main draw of the hero. I'm really worried for Drinking Boys, but I do think Sven's really good with Oracle, because when you have Oracle ulting Sven, the thing is that you don't take damage. So a lot of times Sven has a blink dagger, and you can just blink out of situations where you'd otherwise knock it out of, and you can also blink offensively in the fight. So it's like there's a lot of synergy there as well, and you lifesteal out from the Helmadon. Timbersaw is super, super strong in this patch. Like, it's a lot of physical damage. What's the best way to deal physical damage? Just having tons of armor. Timbersaw is not really going to be afraid of these heroes.
Right.
Dire's pick.
But that being said, with the Timbersaw pick, they've pretty much like shown like, okay, this is offlane Darkseer, this Jug's probably the carry, and the Timber is probably mid. And with that information, you know that like Sven versus Jug, Sven's pretty good versus Jug actually in head-to-head. If they had a fight 1v1, you'd probably win. And he actually farms really fast as well. So for Complexity to deal with that, they probably have to block the Ancients or work with that. But it's also a little bit greedy because like look, they have Sven and Tide. Mm-hmm. Tide wants to farm the Ancients, Sven wants to farm the Ancients. Like, who's going to get it might not be as efficient as they probably want. And, I mean, Complexity, they just need a support hero. I'd say, like, Z-Freak's hero would probably be something that would combine with Darkseer or just some high-pressure hero. Drinking Boys knows that. They banned out Earth Spirit, Elder Titan, Ricky, and Bounty. Those are all heroes that combine with Darkseer.
What about Winter Wyvern?
Winter Wyvern? No, not so much. It's usually want some kind of, like, robust melee hero that can just, like, run at the enemy supports and, like, really bolster the lane of your off lane so that the Darkseer can get a little bit more space. But if they don't want to do that, they can go with something a bit more greedy because they see that Drinking Boys doesn't have like, that much roam potential. I mean, even he could jungle Enigma if he wanted to, because usually the risk of running a jungler is that like, oh, there's a Bounty, there's a Ricky, he's going to come in, and he's going to mess with my farm, he's going to block my camps, whatever. But when you see this much information, you're saving your pick this for last. Like, you can do a lot of things like, yeah, here goes the jungler. So they're like,
Radiant's pick.
They're using Axe as that robust hero. It works really well with Iron Shell, Blink, Call. It's going to be like very effective. I think when EG was playing the 4 position, or when Fear was playing EG's 4 position back in the past, he ran a lot of Axe with Darkseer. Very good combo. So, and Axe is also a really good for Sidehunter because you call the Tide. He can't Kraken Shell the call. And then you just calling Blade and he'll die. Like, that's a really good way to deal with him.
Storm Spirit. Last pickup for Drinking Boys. And that's a hero that, well, some heroes rise and some heroes fall. And I would argue Storm has been on the bottom for quite some time now.
Storm is like a hero that, in theory, he's very good versus the majority of these heroes. He's very good versus Jug. Like, he's very good versus the lineup in general because they don't have any disables, like hard lockdown.
Right.
That can interrupt him in the fight. He's good versus Timber because he can keep up with him, and he has a lot of, he's both physical and magic, so he has a lot of burst, and he typically itemizes to lock down or CC and get attack speed, so he's very good versus Timber. He's good versus Juggernaut. You can't really Omni Slash the Storm unless he's disabled. I mean, it's a risky pick. You don't really see it much often. Blitz says himself it's not viable. Like, maybe Sumel will be playing it because he's like one of the best Storms.
Well, we are into the game, and a quick pause. That means we get to do, and Ben's the one who got me on this. We got to pick our wagers here, my friend, our predictions.
Oh, nice. What is
highest amount of physical damage a hero will do to another in one hit.
Yeah, I'm so bad at these.
I think this game has the potential to go a little bit long. I'm going to say, I could see like a God Strength crit.
Crit?
Yeah, I'm going to go 500 to 750. I think that's doable. Total Wait. Magic or pure damage done by heroes. I'm gonna, it's got to be Limp, right? It's got to be the Timber Saw.
He does do pure damage. Wait, it's magic or pure? Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, I'm going to
Limp for sure.
Teleport canceled by stun. You think so?
Yeah.
Yep, absolutely. The total number of towers killed before 25. I'm going to go 6 to 10.
Same. You don't really see 11 towers going down very often, unless it's a close game.
All right, so our predictions are in. Hopefully everyone at home is making theirs as well. For those just joining us, once again, this will be Drinking Boys taking on Complexity, another underdog story as Drinking Boys. Well, I haven't seen the standings updated lately, but I know they need wins and they Whoa. Need them by the handful. What's up?
Both sports TP'd mid, so they've kind of scouted each other so they can't get those opening wards. And Swindle's build's a little interesting. He has Ring of Bacillus and Clarity and then a TP scroll. Usually you see Iron Talon. Maybe he's going to do some shenanigans with the axe because the axe has Iron Talon. It's not efficient for both of them to be in the jungle, so they're probably going to have to do some like really big stack with Iron Chill or something. I'm not sure what they're going to do.
A whole bunch of items coming out on the courier now. And we'll see where it's going to wind up.
That's just the clarity.
Yeah.
It's catching up to him. Lion starting with boots and smoke.
30 seconds to go.
Tied in the offlane. Doesn't have an Iron Talon. He's going to contest this lane. I think that's pretty difficult for him. Like, Witch Doctor Jug is one of those lanes that doesn't care about Tide because the Kraken Shell doesn't really affect the magic damage that they can put out. Mm-hmm. Blade Fury keeping up with him, and also I think it's pretty necessary to level up the Maledict at least one level. It'll pretty much zone the Tide completely. If they can control the Ancients, then I don't see him laning.
Well, typical the bounty rune.
They're putting Jug mid. Okay, so it's a Timber. So what they're doing is they're just going to... Yeah, they're just going to have Timber 1v1 the Tide, and nice. Timber owns all strength heroes pretty much, unless there's a few rare exceptions, but yeah, it should be easy for him.
Going for the efficiency play, I like it. As the lanes take shape, let's run through the lineup, see who's handling who. It's going to be Shanks playing on our Lion, beginning with Drinking Boys, of course. Mantau going to be down in the safe lane along with that Lion, as we had mentioned, also joined by Sakula, who will be on our Sven. The Tide Hunter taken out into the off lane by Mad. And it's going to be Gedovez playing on Storm Spirit here in mid. A rare chance to see this hero back in action. For Complexity on the other side, Z-Freak and Swindles on the Axe and the Darkseer respectively. They're setting up shop in the jungle. Limp, as you had mentioned, will be one-on-one-ing the Tide here in the safe lane. The Dire safe lane, I suppose, is a better way to put it. Juggernaut's going to be farmed mid by Chessy. And it's going to be Hansiken playing on our Witch Doctor, who's now making his way up to top as well. So with the lanes now, we have a clear picture of what the early plan is. What are your thoughts on the way these lanes are going to break down one by one?
I think top's going to be a crush. They even have Witch Doctor there. It already, like, Timber is going to be having a huge advantage versus the Tide. And look at the jungle. This is really interesting. Darkseer and Axe are literally jungling together. I think they stack two camps. So they're going to go clear them one by one. I think this is something they probably premeditated. Because Swindle plays a lot of Darkseer. Shanks and Mantu are like, what is going on? They're not leaning. They have an axe. Something must be going on.
Right.
Unfortunately, they don't have any wards, though. Because it's really hard to walk uphill and understand. Like, you don't know if they're waiting for you up that hill and ready to call you with Iron Chill or anything like that. So they have to back out.
Well, it's definitely working. If you look at Mad, he's sitting at level 2 3/4. Then you've also got an axe and the Darkseer, who are both at roughly that same level as well. I guess Swindle's a little bit below that, closer to like 2 1/4. Mm-hmm. But it seems, you know, overall, at least in this situation, fairly efficient.
Money changes. Yeah, it is. And Swindle's rotates to the bottom lane. Now he's going to put pressure on Sven, but Sven is working on his way to the helm, I believe, and that's going to give him really good regen, and he has a Mango and a Tango, so he's going to be fine in terms of regen. I think the supports are pretty much just zoning out Z-Freak at this point. Mm-hmm. Probably let Swindles do whatever he wants there, I guess. That's okay.
That's a cool of taking a lot of farm off of the stack camp. And quite happy to do so. I've just heard a hex. That's going to be here in mid. Chessy in some trouble.
Fire and stick.
Ooh. Very quick fingers. Keep Chessy alive. Just at 100 HP. He's going to hang around and soak some more HP. Doesn't have a point into healing ward yet. He does have a salve on him now, though, so should be able to heal himself back up and into good shape. So even though Mad has had You know, some zone troubles. He's still doing pretty well on the tide. He's got 1 point in the crack and shell, boots, and, of course, the stout shield. And he's able to withstand a lot of this damage. He's coming up a level four now.
He's going to be able to stand there just because he's tied under. But, I mean, like, look at his CS. He's he's very far behind, and it's very hard. He might even go down here. Ooh, did he miss that? I think he might have missed.
Yep, he did.
It's unfortunate. And they probably would have got the mid-kill as well if Oracle was at the lion. But they estimated the magic or the stick heal.
Well, there's a smoke picked up by the Oracle. We'll see how they want to get aggressive and when they want to get aggressive. Could be bottom. Shanks has joined Sakula. They're trying to zone out Swindles, who's now level 4.5. In the meantime, Gedova's not doing awful in mid. He's sitting at 13 CS, and that's against the 16 of Chessie, so basically a wash here. How do you feel about the first few minutes of action? Is there one team you think has gotten a little bit more of a lead than the other?
I think Complexity's got more out of the lanes, just because like they have this 1v1 matchup, and they're getting away with the Jug mid. And the Darkseer, they have a jungling axe, and Darkseer is actually able to lane bottom, so you're getting a little bit more. But the thing is that, like I said, Sven's pretty good versus Juggernaut. He's not really being stopped here, and if he can get stacks on the Ancients and take them, if they want to do that, then he's going to be well above the Jug. Because even though the Jug is able to lane mid, he's not free farming the way that he would if he was safe lane.
So far, status quo stays as expected, and as expected on our prediction, Limp moves into the first position so far as magic and pure damage done. Haven't talked about the axe a whole lot. Seafreak getting kind of low, but he'll be fine. He's got Tranquils coming out, so be able to regen, even has a salve if he happens to want to use it. And Limp getting a fair amount of farming done himself, 26, 28 for the axe, but certainly nothing compares to this Finn, as you had mentioned, who is absolutely very, very far ahead, sitting at just about 40 CS. Now they're going to engage. Here we go. Big Timber Chain in from Limp. Shanks not going to be able to make it back, because that's going to be first blood. Draw my handskin. They're going to continue to play it out as Mad looks to be number two. Drinking Boys, little too aggressive for their own good that time around. He's just trying to waste some time and is doing so successfully, but ultimately will be caught. There's the cask and finally the whirling death. So make it 2-0. Complexity taking the lead early.
It feels like they're kind of at a loss, or like they're really trying to force these rotations because they feel they're being outfarmed. Because normally you have like a forced position support that's either dealing with their greed or you're greeting yourself. But unfortunately they have two supports that pretty much have to be doing something in the lanes, unless they're stacking, and it's hard to kill heroes when they're at like such a disadvantage in lane. Like it's very hard to kill Timber, like hard to get him very low. Catching out Swindles is probably their best bet, and like followed by mid. But if the Juggernaut has spin and he keeps a healthy distance and everyone's like filling each other in, it's very hard for them to gank him.
Well, I think you highlighted the key aspect here. It's they have you know, a team that wants to be getting something done outside of the spin, but look at the 5 heroes on Complexity. Complexity's team's about as hard to kill as a lineup can be. You've got the Darkseer with Surge, you've got Timbersaw, which speaks for itself, both extremely survivable with the Timber Chain. You've got Juggernaut, who can spin and get himself to safety. You've got the Axe, who is naturally tanky as well. And then you've got Witch Doctor with heals. So no matter who you catch, you're going to have to work about 50 to 100% harder just to bring them down by nature of how the heroes work.
Yeah, and like, the thing about Complexity, too, and this is showing right now, that they heavily focus on the lanes when they draft. So, like, you can see how far behind this Tide is from the Timbers, half of his CS. And they're getting pretty much what they want out of every lane just by drafting the way they do.
And now Mad's probably dead if Siegfried can catch him and get a call. Good body blocking by Limp. He's got him.
He's going to wait for the ulti. Oh, misses the ulti.
Lol.
Yeah, nice try.
Yeah. I guess didn't necessarily have to call. Either way, Tide dies, and he dies short of level 6, and he is nowhere near any item, be it Arcane Boots, be it Blink, or be it Mechanism, or whatever build he wants to go. He's level-wise not in bad shape, but his itemization is trashed here.
Now, they're trying to give Lion the lane bottom, so Sven's just going to farm the jungle, and hopefully Lion gets a 6 and Blink. Probably just the 6, I don't think he'll have enough time to invest from the Blink. And the Sven should pretty much just jungle nearby and gank the Darkseer if he's ever out of position. It's going to be really efficient for their team, as opposed to what's been happening in the early game, so that's one good thing for them.
Onskin going to TP out. A little bit of aggression at top, but Nothing doing on both sides. Meantime, Axe making his way back to base. Not that far off his blink, about 800 gold at this point. I feel like that's... Would you... Oh, hang on. Chessie caught by Godova's. Godova's actually done a pretty good job here. 42 CS to the 39 of Chessie, so he is finding some farm. And Chessie caught from behind, but Z-Freak there to bail him out. I was going to say, what do you think is going to be the word go for complexities? Like, what's the item? What's the timing you think they're aiming for?
I think Axe Blink is one of the big ones, and that's and probably the mech with the Darkseer. I think between those two, they're going to have a pretty significant advantage. Like, they'll be able to jump pretty effectively, and they're going to have the sustain. Usually when you have like a mech over the opponent, you're going to have some like you're going to have that big advantage where like they don't want to fight you, but if you get somewhat forced to the situation with like a smoke on the Axe and maybe a couple more heroes, you're going to be able to get a free tower off of that.
Sven continuing to farm up. We'll see what direction he wants to go with his build. Blink on, usually a good follow-up, very standard stuff. And in mid, everyone kind of beginning to hover around. Looks like they might want to make something happen, but for the most part, these teams are quiet. Complexity's just kind of found three kills through overextensions from DKB, and other than that, they haven't even had to be that aggressive.
Yeah, they're pretty much just farming up, getting their item timings, and they don't seem too worried. They haven't even tried to block the Ancients, knowing that DKB has two Ancient Farmers on their team. It looks like they're going to just go for the farm game.
No, farm game favoring Sakula at the very, very least.
This Storm Spirit's going to need to try to pull a lot of work here. He is very hard to counter on Complexity's side, except besides the Axe, so he has to be wary of that. But if he can get some early snowballing on the Blitzstone, it's very powerful.
They're going to try to catch Z-Freak, and they're going to find him. Good kill for them, as they're going to make it onto the board.
I think he just ran through a ward, and they just spotted him and countered him.
They had just smoked, actually.
The smoke?
Yeah, there was a smoke right before.
But what about the Axe? Didn't the Axe just...
Yeah, no, it's a, like, I didn't see if he ran through a ward. I know that it was a found kill, one way or the other, but I know that they had just smoked, like, just to the south of him, so...
Let's see, Lion, almost level 6. He should buy the Tome of Knowledge. Yep, there it is right there. Is this all Tide has? Let's see.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's very behind, and it doesn't seem like he's going to get the Ancients. I don't know if... I feel like you can't really afford to take the Ancients away from the Sven, even though Tide like really wants it. Mm-hmm. Because Sven's one of those heroes where you want to be ahead and stay ahead and use that advantage where like Sven can pretty much farm faster than many other heroes in the game just because like Ancients got nerfed. And only like there's only a couple of heroes that can clear very efficiently these days. That used to be the crux of like Evil Geniuses lineups and success when they won. They heavily abused the Ancients.
I'd say, like, especially for... If you go back a patch or two, Angel was always all about the Ancients, man. You know, going back to... Hell, even the days of Tinker, etc. Like, the Ancients were... Like, you know, and I guess while we got to pause, that's a good moment to transition to a question I'm sure... You know, as a pro caliber player, our viewers at home would love to hear is, how do you feel about that? How, you know, you were around as long as anyone, and we are coming back into it. But do you think the Ancients need a nerf? Do you think they were nerfed appropriately, over-nerfed, under-nerfed? Like, what are your thoughts?
It seems like they're in a good spot.
Yeah. Because
you don't see those gyrocopters dominating games anymore, taking the stacks, and he was probably one of the main abusers. You really only see a handful of heroes being picked that do Ancients, and even then it's not... Like, Sven was very, very, like, meta pick. He was very popular for a bit, but he kind of calmed down. It's not like he's severely overpowered or anything like that, so I don't see very many like, overpowered Ancient Farmers compared to the past.
And I'm actually surprised Chessie didn't just ult there. I guess the Oracle was in range, so understandable why he wouldn't want to waste it. Some attempt at pressure from Call down here at bottom. It is just Shanks by himself. I'm not sure if they've realized that yet, though.
Yeah, they probably know. He's level 6, so that's a little scary. Swindle's about 300 from mech. It's very close. And Axe has kind of slowed down a bit. I thought he was on track for 13-minute blink, but I think he's been doing a little bit more roaming, and that death top really set him back. So that was like a very nice kill for DKB. Otherwise, they'd be under a lot of pressure right about now. Storm initiating on bottom.
Here we go, coming in. Swindle's in trouble again. There's going to be a cast. Very good cast. Oh, beautiful vacuum wall. And the dunk to put a cherry on top as Complexity had folks in the right place at the right time. And unfortunately for DKB, they once again go fishing and don't find anything biting that's not biting them in the ass. Make it 5-1, Complexity building on their early game lead.
He just got so greedy with his finger. It's like it's one of those situations where a lot of very good players will not ulti in situations where many people will. But in one of those situations, beggars can't be choosers. They really should have just taken the free kill there, and they got punished by the vacuum otherwise. At least they do have finger now. I mean, let's see. He's so close to his blink. Let's see if he gets it. Yeah, he did. Okay. So Z-Freak really doesn't mind. He's like, I know Z-Freak's personality is probably like, well, I got gank, guys, but I got my blink. It's fine.
Oh, Z-Freak actually makes it away.
What a player. Did they? Maybe
they blew Ravage for this.
Maybe they clicked on his inventory and knew he didn't have a TP.
Oh, they missed it again.
Oh, they're not even going to try. Wow, what a player.
That's actually absurd. They blew Ravage for that, man. They blew everything for that. Echo Saber up on Sven, limp.
He built a Vanguard on accident and then disassembled it. Breaking down radiant structures like this. Here's the timing. Darkseer had the mech. They're just like, okay, let's go mid. They know that the Ravage was blown. It should be an easy objective for them. DKB should probably have zero confidence taking this fight now.
Look at Z-Freak, man. He's still hanging around here. Ready to engage at top if they want to defend. Doesn't look like they care to.
It's a really good move. Because usually when you're like in drinking boys position, you're trying to look for an equal trade. But since Z-Freak's actually here, they can punish if they choose to.
Yep, shows himself. He's going to go in, gets the call. Trying to drag Sekula back. Swindle's caught as he lands, but Chessie's there too. And Sekula is going to be able to make it away. They don't have anything to turn it around. Instead, they opt to pursue Shanks. Would have been better to get the spin, but I don't know. They're going to be too upset with keeping their tower alive, not quite in deny range. Probably the only thing the way that could have been better is if it had been right at deny range.
But yeah.
They get the kill and they're rolling.
This tower is very important because it allows the enemy team to control your forest. And the fact that it's still up right now means that that's one part of the map that DKB won't be able to farm until they take that tower. And probably like at this point they know that in order to take a fight they're going to have to use Ravage, so the fact that they're limited like this and the tide is so behind is a bad look for them.
It doesn't help when you blow Ravage to kill a solo axe and still don't kill him.
Radiant's top tower is taking hits.
So Axe has his blink. The Radiant lost the top tower. He's pretty much done. Like that's all he really needs to be contributing. Let's see what Juggernaut wants to go for. I think he's likely to go for either Battle Fury or Manta into a Battle Fury. Like,
this is a big get if they can get it. Nope, not going to pursue. May take his stacks, though. No, it looks like they want to focus on Tide. A lot of damage done,
so
and there's the Omni.
Nice finger on Darks here.
Try to turn around, they will find Hanskin. They're going to... It looks like they thought about re-engaging from behind. There's going to be the call. Got a couple, now they're going to spin to win, but the damage is so huge from DKB. Triple kill for Sekula, and this is going to be a full five-man wipe and a triple kill for Sekula Sven. And just like that, a game that seemed like it was on the verge of getting out of hand is instead, if not back in hand, at least back to being reasonable for DKB. That is a 3,300 gold shift in just a couple of swings of Sven's big sword.
Wow, and that's exactly what a Storm pick wants to see. When you can accelerate a hero, much like an Ember, it's like a totally different hero than when it's from behind. The fact that he moved up to third in the net worth is huge for him. With the recent Bloodstone buff, I think that Storm is actually viable in some situations, and this is probably one of them because he's able to deal with the Juggernaut, he's able to deal with the Timber and the Darkseer with one pick, so it's very, very good.
There's just so little lockdown for Complexity. Like I feel like if there were more stuns that were reliable, it'd be a little more problematic. But as it stands, like you said, they basically got call and then the first little burst that's guaranteed off of Kask.
Mm-hmm. And that's weird because like all this fighting went under a Complexity ward, so they Should have seen most of that coming. Seems like, I don't know what it is today, but their composer seems a little off.
Yeah, it's DKB is happy to take it, though. They were on the verge of 7,500 gold down. They've cut that down about 5,000, all said and done, when you factor in the aftermath, not just of that, you know, not just the fight itself, but the aftermath. That was, I mean, cannot overrate it. Your DKB, you just took that fight, Fluff. What's the next step? You know you're now back in this game. It's much more manageable. What's your plan other than farm spin? Like, no matter what, farming spin is going to be part of it. And here we go, Chessie. Cop, follow, and
oh, the
Complexity.
Mech was huge.
We'll be able to get Chessie out of trouble. Let's see
this
how much they want to commit
blood
to this.
Stone.
And still trying. Still
oh,
trying.
No.
Oh, four-man vacuum wall.
But the
Duck
Bloodstone heals them all.
Oh, there's the
Ravage
as well. So here we go, trying to bring it back in. Lip's going to try to clean this up. Mantell might not be the right target. Hanskin on the run. Swindles is behind him. Shakula caught and stunned. Now let's see if they want to turn it. They do manage to track down the Oracle behind that. Finally, they're able to bring down the Witch Doctor. Now Shakula pursued out by Limp. Limp using that surge to catch up. Uses the ult. And they should be able to finish him off, and they will. So what looked to be a total disaster for DKB almost turned into a one fight and unfortunately turned against them again as the reinitiation was there. 3-for-4, but more importantly, the momentum back solidly in Call's camp.
That was such a huge combo, and it's really awesome to see that, you know, the brotherly synergy there. Mm-hmm. Swindles and Z-Freak able to land a four-man call is massive, but the Bloodstone perfectly timed from the Storm Spirit. Like, he just picked up that item from snowballing a couple of kills earlier, and it completely saved their team from absolute chaos.
Yeah. It could have been awful. Could have genuinely been awful. Instead, it's just kind of bad.
And we see Lion's finger still up. You know, like, maybe, I don't know what the situation was, but maybe he could have got a kill with that.
Yep.
I don't know if he should be holding that. The mech on the Juggernaut saved him so hard. It gave him just a little bit of extra HP that Storm couldn't finish him off. And if they picked off the Darkseer right there, or the Juggernaut right there, it's a completely different fight.
If they pick off the Juggernaut, it's probably no fight at all.
Yeah.
Probably just turn around. Nonetheless, the game rolls on. We're at 22 kills in 19 minutes. And our tower count was way off. We know that.
Mm-hmm. This is a much more competitive game than I kind of anticipated.
Yep. I agree.
Lion's very close to Blink, 1700. It'll take him just a few minutes here. It looks like Oracle's going for Aetherlands. That's a really good choice. Maybe questionable and confident, too confident from DKB where they took that fight. They thought they were ahead, and they kind of clumped up. Like, Oracle, generally, you want to stay far back, ready to counter-initiate. Him getting involved in that call and having to ulti himself is a pretty big deal, so hopefully he fixes positioning and Aetherlands will help out a lot. Tide is very good versus Complexity's lineup. He's going to serve the function of doing this massive counter-initiation. Complexity is always going to be looking to jump in, always going to be looking for those huge combos, and if Tide can land Ravage, it can completely swing the fight, so Complexity has to be aware of Tidehunter. Probably they should either lock him out or not commit too heavily. Well,
speaking of committing, they are going to go back in. DKB thought they had a free one, and it was anything but, as Z-Freak makes it a double kill with the ult, and they're going to go ahead and try to chase them down. It was the two supports brought down, so they will respond relatively quickly. One thing that DKB is doing that I like, though, is focusing farm on the Tide, just letting him stay out of things for a bit. Looks like they should get this Roshan relatively easily, though. Battle Fury is up on the Jug as well.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no, they're good. Z-Freak went in along with Limp on top. There's going to be the Ravage. You've got them both. They're able to bring down Z-Freak, but now the Cavalry is going to arrive. Limp helping himself out with the Lotus Orb, and now Gedovas could be in some trouble. He's going to go ahead and grab Hanskin. Hanskin trying to heal through it. Gets Gush. Doesn't matter. Mad doesn't have enough damage. Limp still trying to chase him down. He's out of mana or damn near, and it looks like Mad's going to be able to make it away. And they do only they only lose one. I should say it the other way around. They manage to get away having taken down one. Does DKB. Yeah, that's not bad for them at all.
That was some fancy footwork from the Storm. I thought he was committing way too hard for the Witch Doctor, and then he just did a 360, turned right around, and got out with the Juke. That was really nice.
Chessie, though, in the meantime, is taking a relatively big stack down here. He just finished his Battle Fury seconds ago, and now at top, Shanks using the hex, trying to get himself out of trouble. That's going to be a free one.
Oh,
no, he missed him. Doesn't matter.
Okay.
Yep.
That's going to slow him down with his blink. He really, they should kind of devote some time. He should say, hey, team, I'm close to my blink. Can I just get a lane for a second, or can you help me farm some neutrals? Mm-hmm. It's very, very impactful if you can get it.
So we need to farm in neutrals again. Tide has done quite well catching up. He's got enough for a blink now, along with his mech and his arc boots. So not the best timings on anything, but, you know, having all three of those core items up at 3 minutes is, or excuse me, 22 to 23 minutes is not that bad. Speaking of core items, how about a BKB for Sakula?
Wow, and Storm gets a kill on the axe.
Didn't even
the
see
solo kill, I think. Wow, that's really nice for them. Okay. I didn't really see what was going down. But anyway, with Sven, this is exactly where you want to be. This is why you can't sacrifice the Ancients for the Tide. No matter what, Sven needs to be at the top, if not far ahead of everybody. So him having this BKB is a very big deal for them. He's going to be able to pretty much choose whichever target he wants and fight with impunity unless the Axe calls him. But he should be pretty aware of that. We also see a Lotus Orb on Limp. I wanted to point that out earlier. We saw Arteezy doing that on Secret earlier.
Mm-hmm.
It's just a really cost-effective item. There's not very many items you can get for armor these days.
Yadovas putting some harassment onto the Witch Doctor, but plenty of folks there to help out.
You see how confident the Storm is, though? Like, this is why it's such a good pick for the game, because there are no disables. And
yep.
There are teams like this, and they have players who are confident on these like slippery heroes. And when you're the captain, you say, "Hey, like they have no disables." Someone will point out, like, "Oh, this hero is really amazing. They can never kill me. Like I feel so confident. Mm-hmm. Pick it for me." And you're just like, "Okay." And this is one of those situations, I think.
Well, it's showing. He's definitely having a very, very good game. Not quite tops in terms of net worth, but. Certainly not trailing that far behind the rest of the packs, Finn and the Timber, number one and number two. But he's right there with the Jug, which is not very bad.
And the Storm is really close to Orchid, actually. That's a really big deal. Orchid allows him, because the Jug didn't go for Manta first, he's going to have a little timing window where he can silence the Jug and actually just pop him off. It's especially good versus Darkseer, but he has Greaves now, so that's not going to be effective. He can pretty much use it like in the middle of the fight when he knows a couple of these abilities or items have popped off, and or he can finish off a support really quickly. The Orchid's massive item for Storm. Storm needs to always get attack speed. He's one of those like rare intelligence heroes who really benefits from attack speed and wants to have tons of it. Orchid's the best item for him. You never see like very many intelligence heroes go for Orchid late, because it's generally regarded as an item that falls off. But for Storm, it's one of the best.
Up engagement. Sea Freak, there's going to be a Ravage too! Oh. Caught a bunch, and now coming in to get Ovis. Let's see if he's got enough to bring them down. They're a little spread out, is Drinking Boys. Sakula did use the BKB. Chessy next on the list. There's going to be a vacuum. Stormhammer is actually perched off by the Blade Fury. They're still trying to chase him down. They're going to be careful. They're going to group up a bit too much.
Storm's going in.
Yeah, he is. He's just going ham. And now Swindles next on the list. That's going to be 4-0, my friend. Yeah, that's
Drinking
a double
boys
kill.
Are doing it.
I can't believe it. Like, this could be arguably the biggest upset of the quali so far if they're able to continue to push this.
Yeah, I would say so. I mean, FDL versus Complexity, people say, you know, FDL has a chance. They have a pretty good chance. Drinking Boys, people heavily underestimated them. And in their matches, like, no one really thought that they were going to be a competitor. But it seems that Complexity is actually being challenged by DKB right now.
I mean, just getting caught out at an odd angle there, and then it seemed like when they went in to try to fight, they just didn't have a game plan. They just went in and started right-clicking stuff. And that's usually not going to get the job done, especially against, again, a Storm Spirit who is quite literally just doing what he wants. There's almost nothing Complexity can do to slow him down or even to make him feel scared about just jumping in at any point.
He really doesn't care. And that's such a good read from DKB. Like I said, the Sven, he only needs to care about the axe.
Sakula got caught. He BKB'd and wanted to teleport away, and now they're just going to go ahead and go for it again. There's going to be a two-man Earth Spike, and they're going to try.
There's the Orc ulti.
Yep, Z-Freak is there. Hanskin trying to keep him alive.
Nice
Sakula
cutting.
Is able to make it away. He's going to run into Swindles and go to work there.
Ooh.
Here comes Z-Freak. There's the vacuum. Yep, that's a really, really clutch kill they absolutely had to have.
Gross. Invisibility. DKB sticking around a little too long. I did see Complexity TPing in when they were pushing the tower, but I didn't anticipate them actually converting that to any kills. I thought they were a little bit far behind in positioning, but yeah, DKB getting a little cocky here, and they're going to lose Roshan for it. This puts Chessie closer to his Manta, which is a huge deal since now he's not going to be really an easy target for Storm anymore.
Sven back up at 34 in the meantime. Z-Freak with an invis rune trying to find someone, and he did. Found Mantel.
He won't go for that because no one's following up. Smoke from Complexity.
Let's see if they can find anything. Z-Freak did lose his invis. Does have a blink and a force staff at this point, so his mobility is through the roof. There's going to be the jump ahead.
Whoa.
They gonna, nope, can't catch him. Again, they have no answer.
He literally storm ultied into five heroes and they couldn't stop him.
Yeah. They don't have stun. The best they could do is call him and then hope they get one bounce cask. Maybe if they're lucky too, if there's something around.
Radiant's mid tower could use a hand.
Well, Complexity seems to be composing themselves again. It's a good thing that they're not like feeling the pressure. I mean, sometimes teams, when they lose, especially the teams that they feel like they're better than, they might get a little tilted, but Complexity's keeping cool head, sticking together, playing safe, and they're still keeping their advantage. Mm-hmm. And you saw how easily Sven was kited in that fight, where he went for the timber, he couldn't kill the timber, he stuns the axe, he couldn't kill the axe runs away with the healing ward, and you know, without his team, he can be isolated pretty and kited pretty easily.
And the five man's definitely on for Cole. They are not splitting up across the map much at all, and most it'll be Darkseer going to push a lane out or something. But for the vast majority of the time, they are just roaming as a team, which seems to be the right call. Shanks is hiding in the woods, hoping to catch somebody out.
Swindle. Here we go. They have to pull and Orchid at the same time. He didn't activate his Orchid rune. It's pretty weird.
Now Z-Freak's there. Gets the heal on.
Okay. Misplay.
And they're going to get Shanks. Yeah. There's nothing he's going to be able to do. It's tough to gank a guy like with those heroes who's got Pipe and has Greaves.
Yeah.
Like, that's just tough.
It was a high-risk play, I think. Yep. They would have to blow everything and do it properly. I mean, he didn't proper Arcane Rune. I don't know if it would... I don't think it would have made a difference, but you can't just Orchid and expect to, like, kill the Darkseer with Greaves. You have to Orchid and pull to get that damage amp.
Radiant's top tower is hurting.
Oh, top tier two. One of only two outer tier towers remaining. DKB now going to drop. DKB in the meantime is hanging around the Roche Pit, the secret shop area on the Dire side. And we'll see how they want to proceed. They already have rotated Swindles back to bottom. And he may end up dead up. He's going to run right into Mantel, vacuums, and runs right away. So not even going to try to fight there. Instead, just wanting a annoyance. They're going to catch Z-Freak. Chessie's right there. They just can't do anything to stop him.
Oh.
Can't do anything to stop him. Somebody's got to get a Hex, man. It's got to happen.
These Force Staves are doing work. Force Staves generally one of the best items versus Storm. Like, any hero can get it. It's really amazing. Because you can kite him. And he doesn't really want to be jumping so often with these mini jumps. Especially, like, when he catches someone initially, he wants to be pounding on them.
Mm-hmm. Shikula. Being chased down. Chessie does have level 3 on me. Slash. Here's the blink.
Do something about that bottom tower.
Up. Courier. They do manage to find Mantel, though. Easy kill. And we'll see if they double back and want to go take a run at tier 2 mid.
Refresher on Ty is actually really farm now. It's crazy they came back.
Well, he's kind of been out of the loop, though. Like, they've intentionally taken him out of most of the fights and most of the action.
This Refresher is really big because Complexity in those long drawn out fights, they are a little bit better, but like, if he can get two consecutive Ravages, the Storm will pretty much have his way with anybody.
Speaking of having his way, Shanks just took it without moving. It's not even alive long enough.
Oh, Mantis down.
Oh, Chessie, will they get him? Swindle's there once again. And he's got low mana. They want to try something cute. There's going to be the cask. Jesse, yeah. Like, literally, they just stopped. There were three of them there, and they just decided not to even pursue him because there was no chance, even if they caught him, they were going to kill him.
Storm is just barely out of reach of these kills. It's always like that last 10% that's evading him.
Yep.
He's like, he's just, I don't know. It's partly because he's going for solo kills, but I mean, like, he's feeling really sad right now. Probably, like, last three kill attempts he went for has been countered by, like, complexities, team
Radiant's
effort.
Mid tower's getting banged up. Radiant's toughened up their structures.
Being eyeballed by complexity.
Radiant's mid
Aegis will be reclaimed, so the respawn in about 4 minutes. And here we go. Genova's back in.
Oh, he pulled himself.
Lotus Orb used very well. And Sakula, there's going to be a Ravage actually catches too.
He doesn't have mana. Okay, Arcane
Boots. Oh, he does now.
There you go.
Limp. Caught from behind. Swindle's trying to make a run for it. They can't kill Limp.
Got the vacuum off.
This is looking real bad. There's a good Omni Slash, though. Can they follow it up?
Huge
Limp coming back in, using the Shivas, and now they're in some trouble.
Storm is bailing. TP's out.
Yep, there's the call and Shanks. Next on the list, double kill as Z-Freak posters him, gives him the dunk treatment. And now the tier 2 mid will drop. That actually looked like a really good fight from DKB. Good patience from Cole. And you know, I'm sure you caught it more than I ever would. It seemed like the damage was there for DKB, but it seems like they didn't finish off enough of their targets. Like they just didn't commit and actually finish targets off.
Hey, I think they didn't. They got confused by the invis.
Z-Freak caught from behind. Now Chessy and Limp in some trouble too. Manta's there from Chessy, and Limp happy to use his Timber Chain. So they end up losing one, but not before they're able to bring down the tier 2 and not quite get some damage. Not at least they threaten the tier 3.
Timber is just a monster. Did you see that fight after they vacuumed 4 and the Timber just Timber Chained across and just did massive damage to the entire DKB team?
With the Shivas?
It's insane damage. And he's near impossible to bring down at this point.
His Bloodstone charges keep creeping higher. He's up to 21 at this point.
The problem for this Sven is that his BKB charges are going down. You really want to be winning these fights when you're using these high BKB charges. Once it's at 5, Complexity will know that they can just wait it out. That's a huge disadvantage for DKB.
That's already down to 7.
And it's also a little unfortunate in the last fight. The Ravage, he didn't understand that he didn't have enough mana.
Yeah.
Probably miscalculated. And he had to, he arcane booted 1 second late, and the Ravage pretty much lost one of the kills for them that they were focusing. Mm-hmm. Daedalus for Sven. That's pretty big. But I don't know how effective it'll be versus like the Timber. I think they need to start finding squishier targets.
Here we go. Genova's coming in, and again,
he cannot do anything.
Having his way, man. There's just nothing they can do.
At the same time, he can't kill anyone because Complexity's itemizing so well. They have the Greaves ready. They have Lotus Orb. They have Manta and Glimmer Cape. Like, there's so many things that can mess with the Storm's head in the fights. Just having his targets being juked or juking him all day. It's very good itemization from Cole.
I'm taking a look at the gold graph. We can see it is still heavily in Complexity's favor. There was a brief moment in time when DKB stopped drowning and lifted their head off the bar and were just a smidge ahead in both experience and gold, but that is long since come and gone. Now down almost 7,500 again as we surpass 35 minutes into this game. BKB's on the way for Z-Freak, so a little tired of dealing with Storm's BS. The Basher did complete on the Juggernaut. And definitely just heard a crit, so that's a Daedalus on Sven.
Once he gets the Abyssal... Oh, and there's a Refresher on Timber, wow. That's huge damage. But once he gets the Abyssal on the Jug, he's always going to have the option to Blink Abyssal Storm. And a lot of times that'll be a good way to kill him. When he's like half HP or so, you should be able to burst him down.
Oh, well, 5-man smoke. They're going to make a run for it.
Invisibility.
And not going to find anything. They actually slowed down a little bit. Looks like they might have had a chance to catch up with the tail end of the group there. Instead, now focusing their efforts towards mid. They'll cross the river and look to find something palatable on the other side. Still continuing to play very, very cautiously. Smoke doesn't have a ton of time left. And it will just expire.
This is good. I think TKB was playing a little bit too greedy earlier. And they definitely got punished a lot by complexity. So now they're kind of sticking together. Aside from the storm, he's just doing whatever he wants. But now they're not giving complexity the chance to pick them off. Because complexity has just been pretty much running around as 4 or 5 the entire game. This next Roshan is going to be very big, and whichever team wins this will have probably the advantage for the next, 5 minutes, because, like, if Storm gets a couple Bloodstone charges in Aegis, he's arguably one of the best heroes in the game, probably top two. He's just so insane with that mana regen, HP regen. Coming back at full, he can do so much. At that point, it doesn't even matter if you die, because if you get a couple Bloodstone charges, you can come back instantly.
One can only hope that the Darkseer for Call is going for eventually a Hex, as he just needs it so damn desperately to try to deal with that Storm Spirit as you were talking about.
Mm-hmm. Hex will be really amazing,
yep.
Especially when the BKB charge goes down on Sven. Countdown 5, and then you just Hex him, and you should be pretty much done.
I mean, the threat of it will also keep the Storm from doing what he's done so far, which is poke and prod and constantly be in their face, just in their hair, messing with
it. Yeah, realistically, if you're Storm, you don't want to be doing that. You want to actually just be getting on top of your target and killing him, moving on to the next one. You don't have enough mana to just keep jumping around, waiting for them to pop out a Glimmer, catch up to the Force Staff. This is way too much time investment for a Storm. So Complexity is just, they're bulking themselves up, and now this is the point where Storm's like, hey, I need another item. Otherwise, I need more damage. Otherwise, it's just going to keep continuing this at this rate.
Well, Jesse continuing to build out as well. He's got 2,900 gold aside from his nearly full inventory. Could sell his Aquilo, of course. He's sitting number 3 on the overall net worth chart. The Timber did surpass the Sven in overall net worth quite some time ago. So it's been a monster game for Limp. And, you know, if they are able to pull this out and stave off the upset, it's going to be due in large part to his play.
Yeah. A lot of this comes down to the fact that, like, now it's more about 5-man. Sven hasn't been farming Ancients as heavily. When he was farming Ancients consistently, he was definitely on top, but now when it comes down to lane farm, it's just way too easy for Timber to outpace him.
Both teams playing very cautiously as we roll towards 40 minutes. We're entering into the later game phase now, Fluff. You know, we've talked about some heroes and everything. Talk to me about late-game strategy on both sides. Give me a couple of bullet points.
Okay, so Complexity is going to... I think they learned a lesson from initiating. I think they're just going to hang back, let DKB try to play, like, get the team fight, and then they're going to counter-initiate with their Greaves or Glimmerclave, force the BKBs, take the fight that way. They really need to avoid getting refresh ulti twice. If that's the case, I think DKB takes the fight easy. DKB, I hope they understand that they really shouldn't be the ones initiating too heavily. Like, unless they can catch Axe out and maybe burst down the Darkseer, they're really... And it's going to be turned on them way too easily. I think Sven can scale really well versus the Juggernaut, but I don't know. I don't see them having an answer to Timbersaw, and they kind of never did the entire time. He only has one death. So I feel
go.
Like Cole has advantage.
Going in on Chessy. Chessy 4-step is going to be a Ravage. Only got the one. Swindles, though, able to survive it just barely. Does end up dropping behind the fight. Godovas comes back in, and that's a very unfortunate time to have to pause.
Oh, yeah.
And it looks like a crash. If nothing else, I guess, suppose the damage is done. The fact they already lost their Darkseer. Their Darkseer being one of their main points of counter-initiation. But
yeah.
This is not looking great for Call. This is a huge Roshan get for DKB.
Darkseer is pretty much the ideal target that they want to take out. That's a really big pick for them because he provides so much utility to the team. He's a lot of auras, turnaround potential, the vacuum. And the good thing is that they don't really have a great way of saving him if they choose to burst him. So, like, really nice opportunity for DKB and really good play for them
to
take advantage.
It's a little suspect that it took him that long to say G after the rejoin.
Nah, I mean, it's Complexity. Like, you really expect them to take the time. It's not like they planned on this kind of pause and, like, strategizing, but, I mean, if it If it happened, it happened. So they're going to take advantage of it. And so will the other team.
All right, here we go. Moving right out. They're going to finish up. Hanskin caught from behind. Drops the gem as well. And Jesse trying to get back
in. One more Ravage.
Oh, wow. There it is. And it got limp.
Huge
and Jesse.
Axe ball.
Oh, yes. Look at the turning around. Get Ovis. Low on mana. Can't do much. Z-Freak's going to run out of BKB. Ends up being 2-for-1, and Z-Freak's going to end up dropping. So Sakula still up and going. Limp needs to make something happen, showing off his scepter. The dual chakrams secures the kill. Let's see if they can chase everyone else down. Mantel moves into the pit and will TP himself to safety. So a very rough fight.
Mid-tower's coming apart.
And it ends up being a 3-for-2 overall. Another win for DKB, but unfortunately for the Drinking Boys, it is a overall win, I think, for Complexity, as they will take the Roshan and the Aegis.
That was a beautiful call by Z-Freak. If he didn't call right there at that exact moment, they definitely would have got another kill instantly with the Sin, but because he pretty much wasted the Ravage, because during that entire Ravage Sun, they were attacking the Axe. Huge plays. Is Storm going to go for the steal?
Let's see if he can do it.
Okay.
A little late there, bud. He's going to get caught. Do they have the damage? Oh, he goes to the high ground. He's low on mana. Oh, wow. What a hell of a time to give up your first death of the game, or damn near it if he's died. No, it's actually his third, but still, his first death in a while.
It's more important that he gave up the six gem. Charges and a gem. That's just like... I don't know. He wasn't even in the best spot, in my opinion, for stealing the Aegis. Like, he could have been a little bit closer. The Remnant probably could have provided a bit more vision, but...
Well, he also went in 8 seconds too late. Like, he went in so late, they're almost out of the pit, and now they're just giving away things as Mad requires help from Shanks to get back to safety.
Blink, blink, blink. What?
And, yep. Dual Chakram. Pretty good ability. This seems like they were in such good shape, and now it just has fallen apart.
Yeah, and...
They lose the Aegis, lose the Storm, lose a gem.
They need that gem, too, because the Glimmer on the Witch Doctor is causing a lot of problems for them. They have to be able to see. Oh, and there's a gem in the base, so they're okay. Storm cannot do the Patch and Tint, like, huge ulti and then TP back to base, because his TP is off CD, so... Or on CD, so that's... Have fun trying to really lame for him. Blue's like, get that gem, you need that. Okay.
Let's see if they can do anything to stem this. Tier 3 certainly going to drop. Lion's back up in 12.
They should find a Darkseer. Yeah, that's the right target.
Up there we go. There's the Ravage, but Chessie was already spinning, and they only got Z-Freak behind Swindle. Swindle's was also glimmered. Now they're going to turn it around. There's the call. Sakura's, this is a very low timing. Beautiful vacuum. The BKB, so low for Sakura, ran out. Gidova's very close to dead. Will be able to make it away by the skin of his teeth. Sakula, not as fortunate. Immediate buyback on the spin. They're going to catch Mad from behind. Down he goes. Beyond godlike strength for Limp. Putting that Lotus Orb to use and just making it so hard to engage into him, zoning heroes out with the dual chakram. There's one Rax down, range next on the list. And Sakula's going to be careful. If this was a die, if this becomes a dieback, he's in a lot of trouble. And yeah, Complexity wants to end this right now. As they've got three down, and it's only the Storm and the Sven. And yeah, Sakula can't even come out, man. He can't do anything.
That was just poor communication and coordination by Drinking Boys. They had a really good initiate on the Darkseer. Well, Dova's going down for the second time. Yeah, they had a really good initiation on the Darkseer. That's the right target, but the Sven didn't blink in, so they effectively used the Ravage while the Sven is like hitting a Timbersaw who has like God knows how much armor. It's just impossible to bring him down, so they're like not focusing properly. Maybe they're feeling the pressure, or maybe they're a little tilted. But yeah, it's a bit odd that they jump for Darkseer, commit the Ravage, and Sven's not hitting there.
Here we go, last hurrah. They get some damage done, but is it enough? Does it look like that's going to be the case? Is Complexity ready to turn this around? Sakula caught from behind and eating a lot of damage. He's going to come out and be able to chop down Hanskin. But ultimately, the damage catches up with him. Chessie actually gets hexed behind it. Looks like Z-Freak waiting on his chance to go back in. Aegis will be popped. Z-Freak comes in to do the good damage. Ravage does go off. Limp and Swindle shake it off their shoulders, though. Not feeling a lot of this. Gidovas dies yet again. And they're just going to chase him back to the fountain. Omni Slash is on point. Killing spree for Chessie. And a game win for complexity. Well, if you're a Cole fan, you definitely had a couple of palpitations throughout this. There were a couple of times it looked like DKB might be able to pull out an upset, but you know, ultimately, man, that last little sequence was bizarre. You know, the fight near the Roche pit where it looked like they were going to win, but, you know, marginally in favor of complexity because they're going to get the Aegis, and you have that weird death by the storm, and
yeah,
things just toppled from there. There's just nowhere to go.
DKB was showing signs of life. Really amazing that they could actually contest with complexity, but overall complexity looking a little shaky, I have to say, from casting through their games, but hopefully they just look at this and say, okay, we just need to step it up next time we play versus EG or anything like that. So just take the win. Don't think too hard about it. Don't demoralize yourself and move forward. But good effort from Drinking Boys.
No, I totally agree. Best that I've seen them play so far anyway. But I do think ultimately the takeaway is while Drinking Boys may have played better, Complexity still really has some wrinkles to iron out.
Mm-hmm.
That's going to do it for us, guys. I'm AC, and that's Fluff. It's been a pleasure bringing you this first day of coverage for the America's Qualifier here for TI6. We'll be back, but don't worry, on BTS in here and on the multi-stream, et cetera, plenty of other coverage of the other regions looking ahead over 24 hours. So make sure you stay tuned, not just here, but elsewhere. And make sure you check out the Score Esports for all your Dota scores, stats, and news. And you can get that on iOS App Store or Google Play. Again, I'm AC. That's Fluff. Enjoy your time, and the coverage will continue. Stick with us.